R. Kelly pleads not guilty bribing to getting a fake Aaliyah ID, even though R. Kelly's ex-tour manager Demetrius Smith has publicly backed the police officer's claim that his old boss had the ID made for his future bride, which was used to obtain their marriage license under false pretenses. But he was on a video call in court yesterday because he wasn't there physically, and he pleaded not guilty to the charges of bribing.
Nothing so exciting about this news. What were you expecting?
Of course,
it will plead not guilty.
I feel pity for Kelly right now because
we all can only imagine.
The whole psychological, emotional trauma is going.
But that's
right
if
now.
He is not guilty.
But this is then they should go ahead. They should prove him guilty already. Don't you get
they
it?
They don't have enough.
Thank you. They don't have enough because the evidence has got to be sufficient.
Mm-hmm.
So the reason why this case is still lingering because the evidence is
another thing you need
sufficient.
To remember is that this these cases are really
evidence.
Expensive. This trial,
yeah.
are expensive. This investigation,
you know why you will not win in a rape case.
Why? Because you don't have sufficient evidence. Yes.
But that is not...
That's why the Bosola case just got thrown out.
But that's not fair. At the end of the day, it's still not fair. If R. Kelly is not going to... If truly is guilty, and then because there's no sufficient evidence...
No, but what if truly is innocent? Why are we so bent on him being guilty?
No. Let me explain what I feel. Because I think on some cases, they have enough evidence to try or to charge R. Kelly or sentence him. But on some other grounds, they don't... But you know what? They can't be doing, okay, this one you're guilty, go. This one you're not guilty, stay. You understand?
Counts.
So they need to make sure
on
that this counts. Is all finalized before they sentence him. Because this, we're just looking at it, but these trials are pretty expensive.
Yeah,
the cost of investigation and all of that, it's so much. So you can't expect them to be doing an halfway cross kind of thing. It has to be all the way. You understand? So that's the way I see it. So it's not about R. Kelly not... It's not about them not having enough evidence. I just think they want to gather all the evidences that of all the charges against R. Kelly
still, that's,
before...
They still boil down to the same thing. They don't have sufficient evidence yet to totally nail
on
it.
Some cases.
On some cases.
Truth is, R. Kelly can't beat this case. Let's put it that way.
Yeah, he can. No,
with everything that's happened and with the media publicity, of course, he's a dead man already.
The way you say that, he's a dead man.
The whole wide world, I mean, when I say he's a dead man, I don't mean that literally.
No,
the whole wide world came out with a theme, Surviving R. Kelly.
Mm-hmm.
Are you kidding me? Almost all the women in America jumped on that, Surviving R. Kelly. R. Kelly became a theme, you need to survive. Mm-hmm. I mean, so already the case has been prejudged by the media. He's guilty. And it's going to be hard for him to get off this case the way it is. Even OJ's lawyer cannot help him out at this point in time. That's why we all know OJ did it.
Okay.
Think OJ did it, but you don't think R. Kelly did
Naira Marley.
It. Sorry.
Speaking of Naira Marley, I thought you had a
confession.
No, but she just called
just
his name instead of R. Kelly.
It's a public service announcement. I just want to declare that I'm now a Malian. But hold up, there's a clause to that. I'm a Malian, but they're all millennials. I'm an older millennial Malian. So I subscribe to his philosophies.
Exactly.
I subscribe to his thoughts, school of thought. You won't find me sagging my jeans, trousers, beltless. I'm too old for that. And so you won't catch me, smoking ash on the street. But to his thoughts, get on Amali's Twitter and see most of the things he talks about. I subscribe to his thoughts, his school of thought, his philosophies, and he has values. So I declare myself today publicly as an older millennial Malian.
I think this is a part where we go, Malians,
Malians, Malians, Malians,
MD, MD, MD.
Welcome to the club, bro.
Thank you very much. But I'm loving that dude now every day. I don't know why, but I'm just loving him every day.
Morning, we're lighter. Lighter on YBN.
Can we move on?